This video will allow you to correct your homework for section 7.1.1. The homework problems are 7.10 through 7.15. So 7.10 says that it took Ivan 7.5 hours to drive 412 and 5/10 miles at a constant speed. How fast was he driving? And show how you know. So what you want to do first is write down our formula for distance. Distance equals rate times time, or rate times time equals distance. And you want to substitute the information that you know. We know the distance is 412 and 5/10. We know the time is 7.5 hours. So what we're going to do is replace time with 7.5. I made it into a decimal. Replace distance with the quantity that we're given for distance, which is 412 and 5/10. And then what you're going to want to do is to set it up to solve. So in place of rate, we're going to use R to represent the rate. So R will equal R rate, and our equation then is going to be 7.5, 7 5/10 times R, equaling that 412 and 5/10. So basically we're substituting our variable term for rate, and then we have 7.5 R equaling the total distance. This is set up as a one-step algebraic equation, so you would divide both sides by the coefficient. In other words, divide it by the time. If we divide by 7.5 on this side, we're just going to get R. If we divide it on this side, we're going to get the value of R. So what you end up getting is 55 miles per hour. For 7.11, you have to make a graph to show the relationship between distance and time for a bicycle that travels 10 miles every hour. So you should either put this on graph paper and insert it into your homework doc, or use Google to insert a graph into your homework doc and then go ahead and use the drawing tool. So first of all, you should have a title on this, and again, labels. So time in hours, distance in miles, and again, whatever title you think is appropriate. And we need to, in a linear situation, graph at least a couple of points. So if it's going 10 miles every hour, that means in 1 hour it's going to go 10 miles. Put a point there. 2 hours, it'll go 20 miles. You could also recognize that it'll go 0 miles in 0 hours. And then the reason that they connected the dots to create the line is because both time and distance can be represented as fractions or decimals. In other words, they did not have to be whole numbers, so we can connect our dots to create the line. For 7.12, we know that 25% of the students bring their lunches from home and 225 students do not. We want to know how many students attend the school. So there's a couple different ways you could go at this. One is that if 25% do bring their lunch, then 75% must not be bringing their lunch. And that 75% represent 225 students who did not bring their lunch. So 75 out of 100 is equal to 225 out of our total number of students. You could solve this with a proportion using cross products. So 100 times 225, multiply those two diagonally. And then you're going to divide by the third value. In other words, divide by 75. And what you get is that there's 300 students. They also talk about having you create a diagram. If you're going to make a diagram, you'd be looking at something like this, where, again, 225 students are representing 75%, and we're figuring out the total number of students. 100% of the school is representing 300 students. We said the answer is 300, and that means that 25% would be 75 students who do bring their lunches. So the diagram would look something like that. For 7.13, you basically want to combine your like terms, make zero pairs, and use the distributive property. So for the first one, you can combine your x terms. 4x plus 2x plus 2x would be 8x. You can combine your constant terms. Negative 3 plus 2 would be negative 1. So you end up with 8x minus 1, or 8x plus negative 1. For the second one, negative 8x cannot combine with anything. So that's going to be left alone. And 4 plus negative 3 would equal positive 1. So negative 8x plus 1. For this one, you can combine 7x squared with the other 7x squared, giving you 14x squared. You can combine 3x with 3x, giving you 6x. And 4 can combine with 4, giving you 8. So 14x squared plus 6x plus 8. And the last one would be using the distributive property. So 5 groups of x minus 4 would be 5 times x. And then 5 times 4 with subtraction sign being maintained. So 5 times x is 5x minus 5 times 4 is 20. For 714, we'd said there was a number of different ways you could set it up and solve it. What I did is I said, all right, if he can do 1,500 words in an hour, that means he can do 1,500 words in 60 minutes. I divided to get the unit rate. He can do 25 words per minute. And since he has 5 minutes between classes, 25 words per minute times 5 minutes means he should be able to text 125 words. And that means he should not have problem texting a message that has 85 words. So, yes, he can do it in 5 minutes. For 715, you want to find the perimeter and area of the original and then also the enlarged figure. The enlarged figure has been multiplied by 2.5. So, first of all, the side lengths are currently 12.5. Well, let me put it this way. Side lengths, once we multiply by 2.5, are 12.5, 10, and 7.5. Okay, so where those are coming from is 4.5 times the 2.5 is how we got the 10. The 5 times 2.5 is how we got the 12.5. And the 3 times 2.5 is where we get the 7.5. So the perimeter of the new would be adding the sides up and getting 50 feet. The perimeter of the original is just taking these values and adding them. This, of course, is still 4, and that would be 20 feet. And then for the area, this is a trapezoid. So you'd want to use your formula for area of a trapezoid, which is base 1 plus base 2 as a set, so in parentheses, divided by 2 times perpendicular height. So for the original, that's 4, which is coming from here, plus 7, 4 plus 3 makes 7, divided by 2 times 4 is the perpendicular height, and you get 22 square feet. That's this answer. And for the new, you're taking your new dimensions, which would be 10 plus 17.5 divided by 2 times the new perpendicular height, which is 10, and you end up getting 137.5 square feet. So that's where that value came from.